All right, and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be talking about a few reasons why I love and probably will stick with NixOS as my choice of distro. I've pretty much tried everything. Arch is my most recent one that I was using, a little bit of Fedora in there as well. I started out on like, you know, Mint and Ubuntu and all the Ubuntu / Debian based distros. And then I think I moved to Fedora and then to Arch. But I think a lot of the things that all of those distros had in common are the reasons why I like NixOS a little bit better. And not to say that any of the other distros are bad. It's more of a preference type thing. You can very well get a good system built on any of these different distros without really having a ton of issues or anything. But for me, being a content creator, I'm constantly trying out new things, new hardware. This has made it easier for me to essentially reproduce my system and put it on pretty much any hardware that I want to without having a huge setup time. For instance, if I wanted to try out some new Dotfiles on my laptop, I can install them. I like to do everything on real hardware. If I wanted to install all that stuff onto my laptop and then do a video on it, but then I want to go back to my setup previously, like on, you know, Arch or any other distro, it was a whole day's time worth of getting everything configured back to the way I want it. I know there are different ways of doing it with scripts and saving your configuration in different ways, but NixOS just makes it pretty easy to do. Everything's built in a configuration and you can just rebuild your system on any different computer that you have. I have multiple hosts within my system. As you can see here, I have the Nix desktop and the NixOS Lino. That is my desktop that you see here that I'm on now, and then this is my laptop, and I have slightly different configurations on both of them, but I can rebuild either one of them on any computer at any time without really any issues and little to no setup just by having this configuration the way I have the host and everything set up on my system. I just like that ability to be able to do that, and I have like little to no fear and like breaking my system. You can try a bunch of different things and not really have a huge drawback in trying things. For one, you can actually add multiple different types of packages without having them really conflict. So if I wanted to add two different variants of the Discord packages, like one was working better than the other, I can install the previous Discord package, a different version, and it won't conflict with the newer version, which is really nice. I just like the ability to do that without having all the dependency errors and have just a bunch of things breaking on you when doing so. So I like being able to do that, not having any conflicts or anything, being able to add different packages in my system. I like the way they do their package management. Instead of having to go to the terminal and either search for a package like in the AUR or using like Pacman or DNF or whatever, you know, system that you're on currently and installing it through there, you would just open up your environment system packages in your config and then add the package that you want, add the name of the package that you want in there, and then rebuild your system. It's just one command to rebuild your system. I'll get to that in a moment, but I think it just makes it pretty simple. The fact that I can see every package that is on my system and not know what is all on there. Yes, you can figure that out on other distros and stuff, but it's just so easy. It's just literally in a list. If I don't want a package anymore, I literally just come here and delete it, rebuild, and then it's gone. I just like this look and feel better for what I like. It was nice to be able to just install a package and just open your terminal real quick and, you know, sudo dnf install Discord whenever, you know. It's pretty easy and inconvenient, but I mean, I'm always in my text editor anyway, so it's not like a big deal to go over to packages and add Discord in the list and then rebuild and then there's your package. It's not really a big deal for me, and I just like the way this is listed out. So that's kind of the reason why I like the package management system within NixOS. And I really feel like once I fix an issue, it's actually fixed. I've been through the rabbit holes of NVIDIA drivers and all the different things on different, you know, other dishes that I have or gaming experiences where I have to continue to fix issues like controller connectivity and stuff like that. But I feel like once I fixed it on here, it's pretty solid. I don't feel the need to have to update as often. For Arch, for instance, I felt the need to update frequently. I know you don't have to, but I just felt the need because it's the latest and greatest. packages in order to have everything running great. Especially with NVIDIA, you kind of did have to update pretty frequently to make sure you had the latest drivers and stuff. The driver that I'm on now has been working great and I haven't had any issues. I just like the stability of it. The stability has a peace of mind aspect to it. One of the things that I will talk about though is what needs to be better in NixOS. I do feel like there are some shortcomings. Everything's not just great. One of the biggest things that I have as a drawback for NixOS is the documentation. I feel like the documentation could be a lot better. Coming from Arch, where everything was described so well, even with Arch and Hyperlin, for instance, everything was described so well. A lot of times you can search for something and it gives you all the commands you need in a list form and it tells you exactly what to do. But a lot of times I'll be searching either in the manual, on Reddit, or wherever for information on NixOS. And even their own manual here is just not the best. They have, for one, they have so many different commands for the NixOS rebuild. It can get a little overwhelming for a newcomer to know, you know, which one to use, which one not to use. When you're on Fedora or something, you just have update and upgrade. And it's simple and straightforward. They do what they do, and then you're done. There is a learning curve to be able to do it, but I don't feel like this documentation really explains exactly what it's doing and why. They kind of give you the command or the snippet that you need to add into your configuration. Yes, I know I need to add this to configuration.nix, but like, where in the configuration.nix does it matter? Does it need to be at the top or the bottom? They don't really give you any more information on that. And it's almost like you need to know a little bit about NixOS before you start reading the documentation to understand exactly what you're doing. I feel like that shouldn't be the case. You should be able to be a newcomer and read the documentation and understand what just happened. So I think that would be the biggest drawback for me for NixOS. I do feel like it just needs a little bit more simplicity when it comes to those things. But once you get used to it, once you get the configuration that you want, I think this has been the most solid and stable environment that I've been on since I've been using Linux for the past 3 years. And I've done my share of distro hopping, not even just for the channel, but for my own personal computers and everything. I feel like I have done my share of distro hopping. And I think this is, I landed on Arch for a while there, but then with the whole like DDoS attacks and stuff with the AUR and their wiki and stuff going down, that just sent me over. I was already having a few issues here and there, nothing crazy, but I could live with them. But once those things started happening, every time I wanted to install some new Dotfiles to try out or do anything like where I needed to have another package from the AUR or update my system and AUR package was involved with the update, there's a bunch of issues and I just couldn't take anymore. So that's why I started looking around and why I landed on the NixOS. I just wanted to share my experience to get others to maybe try it out, see if it's for them. If it's not for you, great, stick with what you got, but it's worth a shot. You can also try out my Dotfiles that you see here. It's Blackdown OS. I'll put the link to the GitLab in the description below if you want to check those out. If you do want to support me, feel free to in the description below as well. And if you haven't liked my content, please consider liking and subscribing. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.